So if you'll notice, right in front of Chad's truck right there, his dad's in a bulldozer. You can see Dad starting to move. I didn't get him. That is a tough, tough spot right there. The object is to try to catch them before they spin any or give any. You see that pine stick laying right there? If you look in front of you, you see the dirt's tore up. And if you look at the butt end of the stick, you'll see where I have grabbed at it with my grapple and kind of grabbed some threads on it, if you want to call it threads. But I show that to say that I can't reach that stick. I mean, I can put my grapple on this machine right there on it. I can touch it with the tongs, but I can't, it's not close enough. It needs to, if it was an inch closer, I could grab it. Now I can't do anything about that. I can't go anywhere on this machine. On my loader, I still could reach that tree right there without even having to move. But if it was out of reach and I was in that same situation, I just touch my tracks, track, grab it, and go. And then I could finish this load right here. So that's kind of one of the dilemmas with this machine like this. Not knocking or anything like that. It's just a different scenario there. Just a completely different animal to deal with. That's a load you just watched me load. So you can see Daz coming down the hill on the bulldozer up there. As soon as Dad gets in place right there, then Danny will come on. Then they'll try to get their timing right. Already tell that truck struggling right there. Dad, get him right quick. Come on, Dad. Alright, he's with him now. So an update on the 635, we should have it back this week. It ended up not being the hydrostats. We took it down to the dealer down there because they was worried that it might have some metal in it and didn't want to contaminate everything up. It ended up being a valve in it. That's what it was. So that's a good thing because it's going to be costly enough. As it is, but it won't be near as bad as having to put hydrostats in it because those things are not cheap. My loader talked to Warrior Tractor today. Got all the stuff in for the grapple on it. The thing now is just getting somebody on it to put it back together. So as soon as they get that done, they'll run it back over here, slap it back on my loader. But maybe it'll be this week. Maybe they'll get it done. We'll see. But that's kind of where we add on all that stuff like that. It's not cheap to log, and if anybody is kind of thinking that you can do this and not have maintenance stuff, big ticket maintenance stuff pop up from time to time like that. Well, that's so far from the case. You have a lot of very expensive moving parts out here on these machines that break, and it doesn't matter who's running it, what color the paint is on it, or anything like that. If it's made, it's gonna break.